Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do duck nails. I don't mean those big, fat, wide duck feet nails. We're going to do some cute ducks. I'm going to use a few different colours. This is Kryptonite, yeah, we've got Kryptonite. I'm going to lay down a background. I want it to be like spring nail, very muted colours, so pastels but with shimmer. That's what I want in the background. So I've got Kryptonite, which has got a shimmer. I've also got Metalic Rose, and we've got Metalic Green. And we've got Fairy Godmother. Do you like my little, little bow I've got on Fairy Godmother? Those are the kind of colours we're going to put in the background. I want to do this really thin as well, make it nice and thin because we're going to encapsulate. I'm going to use high speed for this because I'm going to do very thin layers. I want everything to set quite quick. I think I'm also going to use Infinity Lagoon, throw a bit of that in there as well. Not literally throw it, but you know. I'm going to start with the most vibrant colour at the tip. I've just took my hair out my plaits, and this is when Adam's going to moan at me about my big hair getting in the way of the shot. So this is Kryptonite. What we're going to do is fade those colours over each other. So blend them. So it looks like you fade from one colour to the next. Blue Lagoon. And I'm using everything a little bit wet so I can really blend those colours. This is Metalic Rose. They're so pigmented, you can use them very, very finely, very thin. Don't need a lot, especially when you're laying down a background to work on the perfect products for that. Now I'm going to put Fairy Godmother here. And using a 3D brush, we're going to use Pastel Lemon. So I have my little friend here. A little duck. This is one of my favourite ducks. I have lots of ducks. Moolah.
Bit of moolah.
I like it because she's got pretty patterns on her. And she's like the colours of Port Vale Football Club. And I'm going to use here to look at and copy the shapes. Okay, we're going to do the body first. So we're going to do cute little ducklings. So I'm going to do it quite small. I'm going to get the shape of the body first. So you want a rough shape. I'm not going too thick, so it's not too high. Adding a little bit for the tail, so it curves up. So they're quite simple shapes. I'm going to add the wing here. So I'm not pressing too hard, I'm using very light strokes. Keep those edges nice and sharp, and you can see when you put that next layer of acrylic on, it really brightens up the colour. So that'll give you depth as well. Just going to start to add some shape for the neck. We want a bead for the head. You'll notice I'm always draining the liquid from my brush because I don't want the liquid to feed back into that bead that I've popped down. Just going to add a little bit of a tuft, like a little quiff at the top of the head, tiny, tiny. And I'm going to use metallic orange for the beak. It's a really small bead.
Really small. That's like the smallest bead I've ever seen you do, I think.
I'm sweeping up slightly, curling the beak up a little bit. So I'm sweeping it up onto the face so it really connects to the face. Then what I'm going to do, we're going to paint a little bit. I'm going to use some backing paper from a sculpting form. I've got a tiny bit of polycolour paint. This is navy blue. It's very dark. And then we've got zinc white. A tiny bit of water on, just add that to the white. And I'm just going to do the eye. Now you could use acrylic for this, but it would be very difficult. It is very small. When you paint onto acrylic, it does absorb it very quickly and dries quickly. So any of the moisture that's there will be sort of sucked up by the acrylic. I'm just going to add some little lines here just to give that impression of feathers. And it'll also highlight as well. Then with the blue, you want a tiny amount. Look how much I've got on, the tiniest amount. I'm going to do the iris. I have no idea what ducks for real, like real life ducks, these ducks' eyes are like.
They're just black, I think.
Are they just black? Oh, we've got a cute one here. I'm going to encapsulate that, and then we're going to do the mummy duck on top.
Oh, it seems cruel. Somehow.
What? Encapsulating it.
Yeah.
Encasing you inside.
Flowers I'm alright with, but.
Animals. I'm going to use crystal clear. We want to encapsulate those colours as well. That gorgeous background.
Bye bye, duck.
Bye. Drowned in acrylic. Poor duck. So I'm going to wait for that to dry, then I will file. Oh, look at him in there. Let me out! So I filed, buffed and wiped over with some acetone to smooth that out, and now we're going to top coat.
You just see his little eye looking out.
Come on.
Help me.
Help me, mommy. He's there. I'm going to pop that into the lamp. So what we're going to do, I will put stones up this part here. I'm going to create mummy duck. Mummy duck's going to go here. So we're going to use very simple shapes again. So we'll need a bigger bead because we're doing mummy duck. So they are the same shapes as we did before. So they're very simple. This one can be slightly more raised as well. So that's the mummy duck done. Painted her a little bit. She's got more feathers and more detail because she is bigger.
And she's got feet.
She's got feet and everything. I am going to just go over very, very lightly with some brush on glue, and that will keep the paint on. What I'm going to do now is add a little bit of bling. It's just so cute. So I've got one of our little clusters here. I'm going to put that on. I think it will look perfect. The colours are just right for this design. Pop that on there, on that clear acrylic. Keep it nice and neat. So you can neaten this up as it starts to dry. Then I'm going to use Mega Gloss to add some smaller stones. Mega Gloss is a lot thicker, so it will adhere the stones on better than if you were going to use the Urban Graffiti Top Coat. Urban Graffiti Top Coat is a lot finer, so it's thinner, it won't hold as well. It's got a higher viscosity.
Mm.
We do like that word, don't we? We sound ever so clever when we say viscosity. Don't you just love a bit of viscosity in your life? Aww. Little duckling and mummy duck. How cute is that?
Separated forever by acrylic. How cruel are you? poor mummy duck.
The reason I've done ducks is because I love ducks and I am from Stoke-on-Trent and I say duck a lot. Lots of people in sort of Staffordshire say duck. Like, I like duck.
Awat. I haven't heard you say awat before.
Yeah, it's very, very common. That's very, yeah.
Is that more common than you, darling?
And they say, ayup duck.
Ayup, I've heard.
Ayup duck.
I say, areet.
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 Areet duck.
No.
No, it doesn't go, does it?
No, it doesn't work. Yeah. Areet pet.
Yeah. And lots of people call me mother duck. And they're my little ducklings. So my students are my ducklings. And I'm mummy duck. That's why we're done. The mummy duck nail. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And please subscribe to the channel. All the products that I've used today, all these beautiful colours, they will be listed below. They'll be there. All you need to do is click on them. And ta-da, by the powers of the internet, they will be there before your eyes. Keep watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye!
Duck nails.
Woo! Duck nails. Woo!